In the last video of this thing, we got the turbo all hooked up and we drove it around with it. We had some minor performance gains. We went from 40 miles an hour to 47 on the little strip out here, which is pretty good. We also read the comments and we saw that there were some things we needed to work out with their setup. Our air filter was too small and restrictive. We had to richen the jets and the carburetor, just some other tuning things like the oiling system. So in this video, we're gonna do all that, test it out again, tune that carb, and hopefully get this thing running at 100%. Since we moved into the new garage, we've been trying to get the best tools to make fabricating more convenient, quicker, and better quality. So that's why we got this Rogue Fab tubing bender. It's a pretty sweet unit. It's a roller die system, so it won't scratch or mark up your steel tubing. It's got these clamp blocks here that keep track of your bends and also keep them on the same plane, which is very nice. It's also very strong and can bend thick wall tubing, and there's tons of attachments for this thing. Heavy duty attachments, there's a mandrel bending attachment, so you can do mandrel bends. So they really put a lot of time into designing this and making it very versatile for everyday fabrication for all types of people. Now, if you want to see someone put this together in great detail, check out our buddy Tyrannus Customs. He did a great video, and also Mike Festiva. We'll have some links down in the description. But we got the DIY weld together kit, and it's pretty easy. Just follow the instructions. It maybe took an hour or two just to get it put together. Then we painted it black and silver, and may have welded together a little rolling stand so we can move around the shop pretty easy. And it's nice and sturdy, and it holds our dies and clamps. So that's what we did. That's how we got it set up. And we're gonna use it to do the tube frame and the turbo piping on the rotary ATV. So we're super pumped about this. Make sure you check out Rogue Fab. They have a lot of awesome tools and equipment. I'll have some links for that as well. It's time for our first bend with this thing. We're pretty excited. We're just doing a small bend for the exhaust. So we're probably just gonna go about 15 degrees, but here we go. Yeah, I bent that 1.5 tube pretty easy. So, let's see how it looks.
Just gotta roll it all the way out.
But yeah, nice easy bend, no scratching. Very nice. So first things first, we're gonna change the jets out. We're gonna richen up both the pilot and the main jet. We're gonna do a pretty decent jump from a 320 to a 350 jet in here for the main jet. And we're putting a 50 for the pilot jet for now. We're doing an upgrade for the oiling system. We figured since it was blowing all that smoke out, we were having too much oil pressure. So we did this bleed line. We have a T going in here. None of this is final, by the way. We're just kind of getting our sizing right. So we have this T going in here. So your main pressure line goes up and into the turbo. And then we have this petcock that we can adjust. And that'll let us decide how much pressure we're having. So if it starts smoking, we'll lower it a little bit and just keep going until we have the right ratio of oil pressure and lubrication for the turbo. So y'all definitely let us know in the comments that you did not like this tiny filter. We thought it was a lot bigger when we saw it in the pictures ordering it online, but we got a new filter. This one isn't huge, but we don't want to hit our legs. So this is as big as we're willing to go, but a lot better.
We have to figure out if we're burning oil or if we're super rich. I'm not really sure, so I think we'll lean out the jet a little bit because I did jump pretty high on the jets. So the oil pump is turned way down. So there's one of two things. Either it's super rich, which it could be, or the seals on our turbo are bad. So hopefully it's too rich and we'll just try and change out our pilot and main jets right now and see what that does.
Kind of like the fog machine function.
Yeah, it's fumigating the whole area. It's pretty
cool.
Smoke
screen.
So the plan is we're gonna put our old jets back in since we know those didn't smoke like crazy. And if these end up smoking, we'll know it's the oiling system and we'll have to figure something else out. Okay, so now we know that it's, I mean, the seals on the turbo probably aren't great, but that's not the main problem. I just jumped up in jets way too much, so we'll have to go incrementally, because when it was running with the richer ones, it definitely felt like it had more power, but we're obviously pumping way too much fuel through it. So we can be reasonably confident that the jets were the problem. It smoked a lot less that time. So we're gonna start with just the pilot jet, since I wasn't really flooring it too much around there. And we're gonna step this up just a bit. I'd say that was an improvement. I think it could go a little bit richer. Sorry we didn't get it on video, but we heard a really loud clack and then like kind of a whining noise. So if I was to guess, I think our turbo's done for. Moment of truth, guys. I mean, it's still there. There's definitely an end play. So we'll just see what's going on, see if it's spinning nicely or not. So, I mean, it's spinning. I did hear the weird noises still. I don't know. Maybe $150 turbos aren't the best. It's got some slop in there, that's for sure. So we checked everything over and it seems okay. The engine's totally fine and all the driveline's fine. There's no problems there. We can definitely tell that. But the turbo does have a little bit more play in the shaft. So we're kind of thinking that it might be worn out or we may have kind of cooked the bearings. For now, we're just gonna run a little bit higher oil pressure and that seemed to help it a bit. And we're just gonna keep tuning. And if we have to get a new turbo, we will have to get a new turbo. Can certainly say that we are no longer making boost, and that is very disappointing. I'm not exactly sure why the turbo exploded so quickly, because we have a very similar setup on a rotary mini bike and we've had no problems. That thing has over 100 hours riding on it and really hard riding, so I'm not exactly sure why this blew up. We had our oil going, but we could have just gotten a bad turbo. We'll take it off, take a look at it, but
at the moment, we cannot tune our turbo rotary because we have no turbo.
It still spins pretty freely, which is kind of weird, but it does have a lot of slop, so that's definitely bad. Earlier today when we were driving it, we were looking at the boost gauge, it definitely was climbing. And after it started making its noises and stuff, there was nothing, it just stayed constant. So we're definitely not making any boost out of this thing anymore. Here we go, let's see. You mean, it's bad, but I was expecting worse. Okay. The shaft doesn't look too worn. The compressor wheel is fine. So we can see our problem. If you look here, it's obviously been scraping there and it's been scraping on the inside of this housing. And that was our noise. So this thing's probably pretty much done.
Some of you might have been expecting that, but the turbo is pretty much cooked. It could be just a cheap turbo. It could be our oiling setup, a bunch of other factors. But for now, I think we're kind of leaning towards bringing it back to NA, not to stress out this engine because it was in pretty rough shape when we got it. Let us know what you think in the comments, if we should do that and just rotary ATV or if we should try and keep going the turbo direction. We'll be reading some of those comments. Other than that, you know, it did make power with the turbo for a bit until everything went sideways. So we had a little bit of a success, but now we're kind of stuck. You know, we don't have enough time to get parts before this video is coming out. So we're just gonna have to end it here. But thank you so much for watching. Thank you to Go Power Sports for the drivetrain parts on these things, because that is something that's still been holding up really well. And we'll see you in the next video.